Hi guys, I'm Randy with BRS-TV, and today we're taking the biological approach to managing both nitrates and phosphates in our tanks with the RedSea NO3PO4X, also known as NOPOX. In today's video, we'll discuss what NOPOX is, how it can work for you and your tank, walk you through some common steps for initial setup and continued use, as well as some accessories that can make it easier to implement. RedSea's NOPOX is a single solution, biological approach to nutrient control in the reef tank that provides a safe and controllable nutrient reduction, which has been used successfully amongst a wide swath of reefers with very clear instructions and guidance on how to use it properly. By using a blend of carbons and other organic bonded elements to feed nutrient-reducing beneficial bacteria to help convert nitrates into nitrogen gas and absorb and utilize phosphate, this biological solution to controlling nutrients can be more cost-effective in the long run than relying on more tedious and expensive approaches like water changes alone. On top of that, dosing NOPOX can be super simple either by hand or for larger doses or tank volumes, can be hooked up to a dosing pump for more accurate and hands-free automatic dosing that you can dose straight from the bottle. Finally, NOPOX is also part of an easy-to-use RedSea Reef Care program, which allows for an all-encompassing system of providing major foundation elements, coral nutrition, trace and minor element supplementing, and algae management with NOPOX and testing all under the RedSea name. There are three different sizes of NOPOX to meet your needs, so in a 50-gallon tank at the max recommended dose of 3 milliliters per day, the smaller 500ml bottle could last you about a month and a half. For larger tanks with potentially higher requirements, or if you'd like to stock up, there's also 1,000ml and 5,000ml sizes available. Before implementing any new nutrient control method, it's always best practice to test your water with a high-resolution test kit to ensure you get the most accurate picture of your nutrient levels like nitrate and phosphate. For this, RedSea recommends using their nitrate and phosphate pro test kits, which are able to accurately read down to plus or minus 0.125 and 0.02 parts per million respectively. With an accurate window into your tank's nutrient levels, you can determine your NOPOX dose and desired target range for your specific tank type, which RedSea provides ranges to aim for the best growth and coloration, such as shooting for 1 to 2 parts per million nitrate and 0.08 to 0.12 parts per million phosphate for very common mixed reef tanks. Your required daily dose is pretty easy to determine with the included chart on the back of each bottle, which scales down as your nutrient levels decrease and is based on every 25 gallons of water. We always recommend a slow approach to starting nutrient control methods like NOPOX, so it may be best practice to start with half of the RedSea's recommendation until your testing shows that more is required to meet your specific needs. Along with that, it's important not to dose beyond the recommended amounts to avoid issues such as depleted oxygen levels, as well as overproduction of bacteria that may lead to cyano outbreaks. Lastly, since most carbon dosing approaches may have an effect on oxygen levels in the tank, RedSea also recommends adding an adequately sized skimmer to help oxygenate the water column and remove excess bacteria and wastes. According to RedSea, the protein skimmer also serves an important role in the successful removal of organic phosphate chains. Let's talk about ongoing use of NOPOX, which, as I mentioned, can be dosed by hand on a daily basis, but is likely much easier when connected to a dosing pump. With that in mind, many of the dosing pump options will be a good fit. However, due to the nature of the NOPOX and denatured alcohol inside, it is recommended to avoid acrylic products for reservoirs or dosing lines. Along with that, you'll want to keep it as sealed and covered as possible to avoid higher rates of evaporation. To avoid any hassle from this, many reefers find it easiest to simply convert the NOPOX bottles into reservoirs themselves and dose straight from them. Outside of that, once you find the dosage that maintains your nutrient levels to your desired goals, it can be a good idea to test them with a high-resolution test kit on a regular basis to watch for more major fluctuations and trends. There are some accessories available that we've already mentioned to help dosing NOPOX accurately and on a regular schedule much easier, like simple dosing pumps such as the BRS 1.1 mil per minute pump, which provides a very slow dosing rate for accuracy and to lessen the chances of an overdose. If you have a Neptune Apex setup on your system, you can easily use a single dosing head for the Neptune dose, which will not only allow you to monitor and adjust the dosage from the Neptune Apex Fusion dashboard, but is also able to provide accurate dosing down to 1/10 of a milliliter. For those who don't require automatic dosing or simply like to dose by hand, picking up a graduated syringe or graduated cylinder like these can help to give you the most accurate dose. Along with that, as we discussed earlier, quality test kits are key to not blindly dosing your tank, in which case Red Sea offers the Nitrate Pro and Phosphate Pro individually or in a cost-saving dual pack that saves you about 20 bucks. Thanks for watching, and if you have any more questions that we didn't answer here, feel free to give us a call, send us an email, or hop on a chat. See you next time on BRS TV.